All right, enterprise. Not just a dirty word anymore. Let's find out why. My name is Bruce LeFave. Thank you for the intro, Brian. Again, I'm based in Ottawa, working primarily on the AEM mobile team, and more recently on the phone gap integration. So I want to tell you a little story before we begin here. About a year ago, our product manager was visiting a large retail customer here in the States, and I can't name them, but so it was near coming up to Black Friday, which, if you're not from America, is a celebration of all things consumerism. It's about buying and shopping and everything else, and it's mayhem. And they had an application, and that application had some store hours that were out of date. So the application itself was built for a number of platforms, but managed by an agency. So they had to make a change to those store hours across Android and iOS. And to do so, it was going to be a five-figure sum for each platform to actually make that change. It was only a week out from the actual Black Friday, which of course can't be moved, and they didn't have any time for any other method, there was an emergency meeting called. They pulled everyone out of the meeting that our product manager was in. They had to figure this out. Anyway, when he got back, everyone got back to the meeting. He showed them this demo that I'll show you today, they were just amazed that a marketer, you could empower a marketing personnel to actually make a change to your application. You not necessarily have to deal with an agency, I'll teach you more about that now. So what are my goals here today at PhoneGap Day? This is a different audience than I usually present in front of, but it's awesome. I love presenting to a more technical audience. So selling you PhoneGap Enterprise, not so much a priority for me. Instead, I want to introduce this integration to you, show you what it's all about, and actually show you what it can do. So if down the line someone approaches you with a PhoneGap Enterprise project, you'll know what it's about, you'll know what it can do, and you'll know if it's something that you might be interested in participating in. So my agenda today, I'll give you an AEM, which of course is Adobe Experience Manager, our content management system. I'll give you a little crash course on what that is, what it means. I'll give you an intro to PhoneGap Enterprise. We'll build upon what Anise was talking about this morning. And I'll give you a demo of managing an application, so what it actually looks like to manage an app with PhoneGap Enterprise. I like this quote on Twitter. I think there's some Google folks in the audience. I have no idea, this could be total crap, but the quote reads, "Managing content is hard. We tried it at Google and decided to focus on easier stuff like self-driving cars." So again, no verification on whether or not how true this is, but I thought it was quite fitting. So with that, I'll introduce Adobe Experience Manager. And AEM joined the Adobe family in 2010 via an acquisition of Day Software based out of Switzerland. And since then, I have joined the team. And again, it's a content management system at heart, but really it does so much more than that. These are a kind of a snapshot of a few of the customers that are actually using AEM in one form, one way or another. You may have heard of a few of these brands. You'll notice that Adobe is up there as well. We try to be our first customer when it comes to things like content management. And adobe.com is, thanks Ken, maybe don't email me right now. Adobe.com is running on AEM along with many other large web properties. So at a glance, at a high level, what can you do? And this is a little bit of a marketing pitch, which I apologize for. But of course, you can create, manage, and optimize your digital experiences. And what that really means is up to you. It could be your website. It could be a digital publication with DPS. Of course, it could be a PhoneGap application, a form, your digital assets, any number of digital experiences you can manage with this product. It features a double-click install, which if you have experience with other enterprise systems, you might be wondering, how is that even possible? Like, most of these systems require a database management system or a relational database system, an app server. They require a week-long setup course to be taken before you can even start. AEM is different in that way, and you can actually double-click a jar and have an instance running on your machine in a couple of minutes, which is in itself quite unique. It has a touch-friendly and fun user interface. This is new as of the latest release of AEM, and it allows you to basically modify and manage your content on touch devices such as an iPad. As a developer, you can develop templates for this system. Again, it is a Java-based system, so in JSP. You can also use ECMAScript pages, And lastly, there's a new language, templating language, we're introducing as of the 6.0 release, which is called Sitely, which really focuses on delivering a secure and a nicely separated view of the world between the server-side code and your code, which will actually render into HTML on the client. And lastly, like PhoneGap, it's built upon an open foundation. And what do I mean by that? If we look at the server-side components which build up the platform of AEM, you'll find many open source projects at its heart. One of those is Apache Oak, which is a JackRabbit persistence layer, or rather, it's a persistence layer that follows the Java Content Repository specification. And it's a scalable and highly performant content repository, and it's part of the Apache Foundation. To the left, we have Sling, which is a web framework that promotes RESTful services and works very well with the content repository on the back end. To the right, we have an open source OSGI container, Apache Felix. And lastly, Apache Lucene, which is provides full text search to AEM. So again, like PhoneGap, there are many components of open source technology that actually make up the product. And this doesn't even mention the components we use on the client side. Those would be in a large number as well. Let's talk now a bit about PhoneGap Enterprise. So from the logos here, you can see there's a bit of AEM and a bit of PhoneGap that kind of are coming together here. So at a high level, we're delivering that content authoring to those non-technical users, perhaps your marketing department or your author type users. These are users that are probably well-versed with a content management system for working with your website, but much in the retail case that I detailed in my story at the start, they're probably unfamiliar with how you can actually edit the content of an application in that same way. So we're empowering those users with this functionality. We're providing a command center as well for dealing with your applications. And this is where you would integrate things like your analytics integration, PhoneGap build, and actually push out updates to this app. And on the subject of updates, we're actually pushing content updates over the air, so without requiring a push back to the Apple App Store or the Google Play, pushing content updates via the content management system to the app. And I'll show a demo of that a bit later. And of course, the integrations with Adobe's PhoneGap build and instrumentation automatically instrumented for the Adobe Mobile Services analytics, which, if you're familiar with, will give you insight into your application, such as the following screenshot. What we're looking at here is on the left-hand side of the white panel. You can see that's where the user entered the application. From there, you can see the number of different paths that they actually took through the application. So we can see that, in this case, this is a sample app. I'm highlighting now the gear section. So they would this is an outdoor equipment application. So we're going to the gear section, and the majority of users continue on to season. And if we dug in further, we'd see that they go to either winter, summer, or spring, and so on. So you can see how your customers are actually getting through your application, where they're getting stuck, and perhaps an area that would need to be brought into the foreground if it's being missed, and so on. So you can gain really valuable insights by integrating this type of analytics. And this all happens out of the box with PhoneGap Enterprise. So let's get into a demo, my favorite part. I made a sacrifice at lunch to the demo gods that this would go well. So we're demoing at PhoneGap Day, so I thought it would be cool if my demo is actually, or my slides rather, are actually a PhoneGap app. So you can see this talk itself, it's a reveal.js talk, but it's wrapped in a PhoneGap application. And what I've done is I've actually hooked it up. Thanks, man. What I've done is I've actually created a PhoneGap Enterprise app. So, and how that manifests itself in this is that each of these slides was actually authored inside Adobe Experience Manager. And I've included an update functionality. So my, theoretically speaking here, if you were to go out the night before PhoneGap Day and you were to, engage in a few beverages with your colleagues in San Francisco and forget to complete your slide deck, you perhaps were accidentally overserved. you could theoretically make a change right on your device and push that live to your application. This manifests itself in the form of a shake gesture. So if we shake the app, oh no, there we go. So it's querying right now, I didn't make any change, so it's just saying, the app is up to date. That's just so you, to prove to you that there's no smoke and mirrors going on here. And I shook it a lot, so it's checking a couple of times. So what we'll do now is we'll switch over to Safari. And I'm hooked up right now to an instance of AEM that's running on a machine that's actually back in Ottawa, so it might be a little bit slow. But what you'll see here, this will be your first view of Adobe Experience Manager. When you double-click that jar, it'll open up automatically into the Touch UI, and you'll have a number of samples that you can interact with and play around with right off the bat. And if you were to install this project, which I've included a link to in the deck, it would give you an entry into the Apps console. In this case, I'll open up the Bruce LeFave folder. And we'll see that I've got my PG Day app here, and we'll tap through to open that up as well. So what we'll be greeted with at this point is the PhoneGap Enterprise Application Command Center that I mentioned earlier. So this is where you do things like you'd actually hook up your mobile services account. So you could do so with the app metrics dialog on the top right. You could add and remove content packages to this application. For now, I just have an English content. I could theoretically put different languages on this app. If I scroll down a little bit further, you'll see we can push out updates to those content packages and also link up PhoneGap build in this case. I was just using the CLI to build this application, so I don't have PhoneGap build hooked up right now. But what we will do is we'll go in and let's add a slide to this deck. Let's say I wasn't quite finished and I want to put something at the very end. So here we're just actually browsing the content of the app. And this is my top slide. When we dig in a little bit deeper, you'll see all my other slides here, many sharing the same thumbnail. So we'll put a slide right at the very, end here. So we'll hit the plus button, say create page. I only have one template here, it's the reveal JS presentation page. We'll click next. And let's just say one more thing. We'll hide that keyboard and say create. And when we open this up, again, this is all completely touch friendly. That's why I'm able to do it on this iPad. I don't know of many other systems that can boast that, so I think that's pretty cool. And we're given here essentially a blank canvas. You may be able to see there's a thin gray box in the middle there. It says drop components here. This is what we're actually going to build out our page. So if I tap that sort of hamburger looking thing on the left, we'll open up the components area, and from here I can actually select, I'll just drop an image onto this page. So I'll click and drop on image, drag it over that area, and at this point I can select an image to insert into my slide. I took a picture yesterday of Jesse doing his plugin talk. Actually, I want to use Business Cat, I changed my mind. Sorry, Jesse. I have a soft spot for the Business Cat. So we'll put that in, and at this point we're kind of previewing our slide. It all looks good. So let's go ahead and push this out to our application. It's very PG. It's very serious. It's very serious stuff. So we'll go back to the app dashboard. We made our change. When we view the content sync. So let me get back a few steps here. We'll notice that there's actually a change pending and can be pushed out to our application. So if I open up this item, I'm editing the English part of my application. You'll notice next to the status, it says pending. Apologies for the small text. Oh, I could probably zoom it. No. So what we'll do now is we'll actually push out an update. We'll say new update. We'll give it a name, slide added. And we'll say done. And what this is doing is it's preparing a zip archive that will actually contain only the difference between what exists in my application. There's a timestamp that it has, and it will actually phone home to AEM and say, has anything changed since this timestamp? Because it has, and because we know that timestamp, we will be able to generate the difference between the state of the app and the current state of the truth on AEM. So that was successful. There's one last step. You can create a number of these updates, but actually pushing it out to the app, publishing it is the very last step. So that looks like that succeeded. Say close, and now the moment of truth. We'll go back to the application itself. We'll give it a shake. This was embarrassing demo, preparing this demo. I kept shaking this stupid thing. So here we can see now It's not saying the app is up to date. It's saying we actually have a content update available. Would you like to update now or update or postpone that update? So it's queried. The server has said there's something new. So let's go ahead and actually apply that. Whoops. And I shook it too many times. Later. Really? Okay. There we go. So I saw a little flash there, and we'll fast forward. I made the change at the very end. So there we go. We have our business cat. Our slide deck is complete. So that's just a quick example. I thought it'd be cool than just showing a little demo app. I thought it'd be neat to actually apply it to the presentation itself and show that you can make any type of app. It doesn't have to be a content-centric app or a strictly business-focused app. It could be a slide deck, for example. So let's go back. We just have one more slide here to go. So again, I made this totally open source. You do need AEM, an AEM instance to try it out. But I will post the slides as well in just static HTML format if you'd like to go over those. A few more resources here. If you're interested in building an app from scratch, we have what we call the starter kit, which will get you up to speed and give you a project on your file system that you can then install into a running Experience Manager instance and get up and running quickly. And also there's some documentation here as well. So with that, thank you so much for your time, and I'll take any questions now. If we got time, Brian. I know there were a few from earlier, so if you... Common library is like front-end... the question was, does it combine any... Yes, the client libraries... So client library is an AEM concept where... you can essentially have dependencies in between different libraries. For example, most of our apps use Angular, and if you're using Ionic as well, you can simply include a definition saying, I'd like to include this library. So to answer your question, yes, in the same way that an Experience Manager site works, you can have dependencies on client libraries, and they will be pulled down as well if something changes in the content update, or otherwise just included in the app that is shipped to the App Store. Yes. I'll repeat the question. If you upload to the PhoneGap build service, can you still push updates to the app? Oh, no. What I meant by that was I hadn't put my credentials. So you have to input your Adobe ID. And if you have a Creative Cloud subscription, I think you have unlimited apps that you can actually push to PhoneGap build. I just hadn't configured that part yet. I was using the PhoneGap CLI to actually build the app instead.
One thing to add to that, all of the tooling and stuff that you're used to in the Cordova world and in the other worlds and downstreams like PhoneGap, totally compatible. And so if it works with Cordova, it's going to work with PhoneGap, and it's going to work with PhoneGap Enterprise. So it's kind of the idea. And that's why it was super compatible with things like Ionic. It's the concept. Hopefully everybody builds on the same common base.